Today we're going to be learning how to change spark plugs.
Editing.
We're going to be doing this for our final project. Now first, before you do anything, you want to make sure that the gap between the spark... Yeah, you see that? You gotta make sure that gap right there is the right specifications. And for that, we went to all data. We printed out a chart of the spark plug specifics for this type of car, which is a 1989 Plymouth Sundance. And since it's an 89 and we have a 2.2 liter engine, the size has to be 0.035. Now for the purpose of this, we've already done this, but just to make sure, see, it fits on 0.035. Now, in order to keep the spark plugs and the distributor in correct firing order, we're only going to do this one at a time. So Andrew, if you'll help me out here, I have no idea how to do this next part.
Not a good cylinder.
Start with that.
The easiest one to do. There's the wrench. Make sure it's all loosened.
How do I make sure of that?
Nice.
Now this car probably hasn't had a spark plug change since it was made. So when we take this off, they might be a little disgusting. Oh,
that's
yeah.
Actually not bad though. Seeing how
well,
old
you can
it
see
is.
The corrosion and all that. How he's having a hard time getting it out of there because of all the oil on it. That's not a good plug.
That was really
and
what we'll,
and you can see the difference in it. How this one's all corroded and this one's shiny. Make sure that you add generously anti-seize to the threads of the spark plug before inserting into the threads of the block. Also, make sure to add boot protection, that way when you go to take the plug out of the boot, it doesn't get stuck. So now, put this one in here. Wait, Andrew, I'm gonna change this.
Let's turn that. How do I turn that? There you go. Don't tighten it really tight because the torque on these is going to be pretty low so you don't strip the threads.
Yeah.
Yeah. Seems like a 2.2 liter. Yeah, it's only going to be 14 foot-pounds, which is not, that's tight enough.
Actually, it's that.
It's tight enough probably right now. Do you have a torque wrench?
We don't have it. And being that we don't have a torque wrench today because Johnson left it in his other car, we can't make sure of this, but what we will do is tighten it as much as we can without breaking it. And now, we're going to reattach, if I can find it,
the plug wire.
The plug wire.
This is all I'm recording. It's just one.
Alright. Turn it on. Make sure it works.
Just turn it on.
And now we're gonna turn on the car and make sure that one works.
Notice how it gets in
there. FYI, this car is
really old.
Really old.
The shocks are like...
If it blows up, don't blame us.
I should ask.
Well, obviously it works, so...
Yeah, that's good then.
Hang on. You don't hear any misfires?
That's good to me.
Well, that's it. That's how you change your spark plugs. Also, if you're doing it on a newer car, you're going to have different kinds of plugs than we are, so make sure to check AutoZone and Napa for the ones that fit your type of vehicle. Peace.